Well, do you know that the laws when taking a selfie, I didn't even realize there were laws.
There are laws of selfie.
Yep, after the break, an expert's answering a few of the most commonly asked questions.
Like, she could take a bad picture. Whatever. And Tina McCullough.
But first, let me take a selfie.
Oh, yeah. We got some facts about selfies. Like, legal facts that you're going to blow your mind. I already blew my mind in a commercial break. I just learned something.
All right, well, when it comes to understanding laws, we can all use a little help. As we were just talking about, a selfie is kind of the big thing right now, but there's a lot of things you may not know when you take that picture.
That's true.
Is that right?
We welcome lawyer and author Mona Parsa to the show today. Talk a little bit about the laws of selfiness.
Yes, selfiness. That's a good word. I like that.
You can use that.
I like that. I'm going to take that. Is that okay? good. I mean, a lot of people. Go ahead.
I was about to say, I'm going to take a selfie right now. Okay.
All right, go for
it. You start talking, and then we'll talk about who owns this picture.
He's taking a picture. Let's just say I'm in the background of this picture.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And
you
I took it. Yeah.
All right. Mm-hmm. In that instance, you probably own that shot. But if Melissa was the one that kind of set up your angle, because we all have our favorite selfie signs, right?
Right. So if I told Code, hey, get it up a little bit and take it this way.
Exactly. If you're the one that set the angle, set the shot, set the background, you would actually be the owner of the one, regardless of whether Cody click that shutter button or not.
Even though it's his phone?
Exactly.
It's not.
What?
Doesn't matter. Ye who pressed the button.
Nope.
It's ye who
directed it.
Wow. So let's say, I don't like that picture. You better delete it. How does that work?
It's his. In this picture specifically, it was his. So,
but if I
directed
it,
he can do whatever he wants with it, as long as it's within legal bounds, of course. But
so if I directed it, can I tell him to delete it and not post it?
Then it's yours. Yeah.
Ah.
So even though it's on his phone, I can direct him and say you cannot post this on social media.
Yep.
Now, is this something like 10 years ago we would ever dream that we'd be fighting over?
I mean, were selfies even a word 10 years ago?
Right.
So, but I mean, it was the same instance. I mean, I don't know if you heard about Monkey Selfie. So the monkey actually took the shot. It wasn't the photographer. This was back, a year or two ago, a couple years ago. And the monkey, it's a cute shot. Have you seen the shot? Adorable. But he took the shot. And so, you know, there was a big controversy. Did the photographer who just set up the camera and went away for a little while, was he the actual owner? But he wasn't. But at the same time, an animal can't really own a photo because only humans can. So really, it's open and anyone can use
it. And
the
I can't wait to the day that animals can finally own their photos. You know, I look forward to that.
Equality, rights for all.
So what happens when then, say, it gets posted online? Who owns it at that point and can you take it from that?
It doesn't matter. An owner has the right to do whatever they want with the photo, again, as long as it's within legal bounds. And just because an owner exercises their right to do what they want doesn't then mean that, you know, it's out in the public now, that the public can then use it. There are definitely limitations as far as what you can do.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So say the something happens and there's like a news story.
Okay.
And somebody posts a picture on their Facebook page.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Do we have to contact that person on the Facebook page to
ask
for permission?
The court would say, you know, there's kind of four factors that a court would look to see if someone's use without your permission was fair. And it's different on every case is different. So even if you have one of these factors, it doesn't necessarily mean it's fair. First, they'll say, okay, well, what kind of work was it? Was it more so of a, an educational work? If so, then the court will say, you know, it's okay. That was fair. You don't really need permission for that. Then the court would also say, what kind of use was it? Mm-hmm. So was the use more so of a, educational nonprofit, or was it more so for commercial gain? Because if it was for commercial gain, then it's not fair.
What about in the case of breaking news? Because like a lot of people post online with the
news
fires
reporting, that's
and all
public
that. Yeah.
Benefit, that should, you know, generally be okay. But it's always, you know, safe to report, you know, who the source of that photo is. That's only fair too. So news reporting is generally
It's a little bit different than somebody else taking it and running a commercial
and
making some cash.
Exactly. You're putting it on a t-shirt and selling it.
Interesting. So, okay, what about selfie sticks?
Because
that's like a big thing now.
It's a huge thing. So first it was selfies, now it's selfie sticks, and it's amazing because the law is always keeping up with the times. And there are actually a lot of venues around the world that have banned selfie sticks, saying that it blocks spectator views. In the U.S., Lollapalooza, Coachella have banned them. Getty Center down in Los Angeles, the happiest place on earth.
Disneyland, yeah.
Yeah, at first it was just on rides. You couldn't bring them on. But now they banned them. Just this past summer, they banned them park-wide. So if you want to keep your experience at the happiest place on earth happy, definitely keep those selfie sticks at home or in the hotel room.
All right. Yeah. Thank you very much.
How can people get a hold of you if they have legal questions?
Mona Parsa online.
Okay. Awesome. Yeah. Awesome. Very nice to meet you.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
That was fascinating.
Thank you.
Yeah, it was like, who knew?
All right.
All right. Be inspired.